Hello there. My name is Helen. We hope you enjoyed our previous episodes. Today, we'll be discussing about Gear 2 storage. Gear 2 has a 4GB flash storage, with a Tizen wearable supporting the W3C file API, index database API, and web storage. You'll surely maximize the available storage space for your application. Before we move on with our discussion, let's prepare the things we need. We'll use the Tizen IDE for wearable to create our database application and a Samsung Gear 2 device for application testing. Note that you can also use the emulator as an alternative if you do not have a Gear 2 device. In our video on Samsung accessory file transfer, we made use of the local file storage. This tutorial takes on another approach. As I've said earlier, there are three types of storage available for you to utilize in your apps for Gear 2: the file API, the index database, and web storage. Let's discuss each one in detail. First, the file API. The file API is useful in managing files. This is ideal for large content such as audio or video. It allows you to get file information and slice data objects. It also allows you to read files from the local device file system. The sample code shows how to use the read selected files method. This is accessible through the file list interface, which allows you to retrieve and display file information. The code attempts to retrieve the MIME type. Next, we have the index database. The index database API integrates naturally with JavaScript through its object-based data store. It provides easy lookup and querying. This is best for those who want to store data based on objects. We see a method in the code for calling data relevant to a key value in the storage through the get method. Oh, note that certain methods and attributes are currently not supported. These are old version, new version of IDB version change event interface, and initDB version change event of IDB version change event interface. Lastly, we have web storage. The web storage is a storage area used to save structured data. It includes local and session storage. Local storage is shared within the application you made. Data is conveniently stored within your application because local storage contains an event that notifies the resource of your changes. This is perfect for storing user preferences. The limit for the local storage size is 5 MB per application. As for the session storage, the space is issued per session only. Although it has no limit per application, data is automatically deleted if the session is over. This can be used for sensitive data or temporary information. The web storage is fairly easy to use. Looking at code, here we see how to delete a specific item by using the removeItem method with the data key. The comment below is an alternative method in deleting, which is .clear. But using this method deletes all data within your application. For those familiar with web development, some of these concepts may just be a recap. But for first timers, I suggest you look more into the discussed storage types after this video. Now let's begin coding. We'll do something basic, so we'll start with web storage since it is straightforward to use. Open the Tizen Wearable IDE. Go to File, click New, click Tizen Wearable Web Project. Under Templates, select Wearable UI, then Basic Application. Give your project a name. I'll call mine Simple Database. Click Finish. First, we're going to customize our application's UI. Click on the index.html file. Let's rename the title and header. Rename the title to Basic Database. Then, rename the header to Database Demo. Delete the Hello World line. Now, we'll create four buttons. I have prepared the block of code for this purpose. The first is a click counter. This will be used to get the number of clicks per application session. The next two buttons are Add to DB and Remove from DB buttons. Then, we added a button to check the contents of our storage. Let's check how our UI looks like. Simply launch the Emulator Manager and run an emulator. If you've got a Geertu device, plug it in via USB and deploy the application with that. Wait for it to load. As you can see, we've got our buttons in place. But the S on our last button has been cut. So let's fix style.css to make the text fit and add other customizations as well. I'm adding a font size tile for the body. I will also change the content padding to make my text fit and change context text font size as well. Launch the application again to see how it looks. Now that's better. We'll proceed to adding functionality to our application. Since we created four buttons and assigned a function for each of them, let's create a .js file to handle those. Right-click on the JS folder and go to New, then click Others. A window will pop up and choose JavaScript source file. Let's name it LocalDB. Make four functions. Make sure that it has the same name as the onClick function you declared in your index.html file. The clicker function counts the number of button clicks made during a session. So we type in if session storage the click count then session storage the click count is equal to number session storage the click count plus 1. Else, session storage that click count is equal to 1. Since we want our click data to be stored per session, we used session storage. Dot click count simply retrieves the instances of the clicks. To add an item to the DB, we call on dot set item. We'll store it in the local storage. The setItem method requires two parameters. The first one would be the key value. The second is the data value. If you recall, earlier we learned two ways to delete information from the local storage. These are through .removeItem, which requires a key value, and .clear. For now, I'll use the clear function. but you can toggle along those if you want to experiment with them. Now, to completely set up our DB, we would need to check if we successfully inserted the click count. So, we create an if-else statement checking the contents of the local storage's click count. A corresponding alert ensues after. Go back to index.html. Add the JavaScript file of your application as a source. If you forget to do this, your application will not perform the functions you made since you did not declare it in your script. Now run the application once again. Let's check if our application has contents. Since there's no input, we are prompted with a no database input notification. Click on the counter as many times as you like and tap on the check DB contents button again. We can see that there's still no contents. That's because we haven't added it yet. Simply click on add. And there, we get our desired result. Try removing the contents from the DB and see what happens. Let's sum up the things we had discussed for creating a database for Gear 2. Gear 2 supports file API, index database, and web storage. The local storage is limited to 5 megabytes per application, while there's no limit for the session storage. Don't forget to declare your JavaScript source. The API is your best friend. To learn how to use the other storage APIs, click on Help on your Tizen IDE. Under Tizen Wearable Web App Programming, select API References, then choose W3C or HTML5 API References. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Thanks for watching!